Hello everyone and welcome back to The Perfect French with Dylan. Today we have a very important lesson. We are going to learn everything about oi. On the book it's on page 59 and the recording is number 60. I know that a lot of you feel really discouraged with the pronunciation of oi. I can understand why. However, you already know how to pronounce it. If you have been following the lesson since day one, you already know. Let's see the IPA, maybe you will understand why you already know. For the IPA, we have the O and E together, and then we have the J. So the O and E is the IPA for EU and OE as a closed sound. Then it's followed by the rolling E, the beginning of your yes. So I told you that you already know about the sound, and this is why. We saw the first part of the sound on the lesson 21, so the sound about EU and OEU. And we saw the second part of the pronunciation on lesson 22, the rolling E, and we have been working on it for the last few lessons as well. So let's go back to the pronunciation. If you haven't watched the lesson 21, I highly recommend you to go watch it first. If you have watched it, let's review very quickly. So we have je peux. Peu, so that's the open sound. There's nothing at the end that come and close the sound. Je peux, peu. And then we have the closed sound. La peur, peur. La peur, peur. So when we have la peur, we have the R that come and close the sound. We have seen a lot of them on lesson 21, but what we haven't seen is this sound in particular. I did not want to include it in lesson 21 because I wanted to focus on it on this lesson. But here, the rolling E that we had after is coming to close the sound. It's as simple as that. So if you know the two sounds separately, you already know how to pronounce it. So that was the first part of why I think people are confused with this sound. The second part that's confusing is the spelling. So let's have a look at that. We have four different spellings possible for this sound. The first one is O-E-I-L. The second one, E-U-I-L. Third one, E-U-I-L-L-E. And finally, we have U-E-I-L. So let's see why we have each of them. So the first one, oeil, means eye. It doesn't make much sense, it's just always how it's spelled. It's the only word you will find with this spelling. This word and related words. But we don't have 20 of them, that's the only one. Then we have E-U-I-L, which is mostly for masculine noun. We have E-U-I-L-L-E, mostly for feminine noun, and verbs, but mostly, okay? So that's French. So there's always exception and things, okay, so mostly. And finally, U-E-I-L will be after C or after G. I'm going to explain you why we change the spelling when we see example with this one, that will be easier. Alright, so let's see how to pronounce it. The middle of your tongue is going to touch the palate, this is how we get the rolling E. The air goes through the mouth, this is not a nasal sound. And finally, for your lips, it's going to go from rounded to slightly stretched horizontally. So let's try. E-I-L. 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 Once again. E-I-L. Now, if you put them together. E-I-L. 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 Okay? So let's see examples for all the different spelling. And let's start with O-E-I-L. Like I said, we have only one, it's un œil. So un œil. Un œil. Un œil. And it's an eye. Second one, we have E-U-I-L. The first one, le seuil. Le seuil. Le seuil. Se. Yeah. So for this one, think about the word seul. Seul. Seul, so the EU is a closed sound because we have the L at the end. So, se, yeah. seuil. Then we have le fauteuil. Le fauteuil. Le fauteuil. Le fauteuil.
Once again.
Le fauteuil. And the very famous one that I didn't add to the book for some reason. So I added it if you want to change it. Un écureuil. Un écureuil. Un écureuil. Écureuil. And the next one is E-U-I-L-L-E. So we have une feuille. Feuille. Une feuille. Feuille. Une feuille. Second one. Un portefeuille. Un portefeuille. Un portefeuille. So I told you for those ones that E-U-I-L is for masculine noun, and I told you that it's mostly always the case. So if we see this one, un portefeuille, it's a masculine noun, but it is built with feuille, which is feminine, if that makes sense. Now let's see the most interesting part for me. It's U-E-I-L. This one is confusing just because of the spelling, but I'm going to explain you why it will totally make sense. Let's see the first one. L'accueil. 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 Once again. L'accueil. Accueil. Then we have un cercueil. 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 Un cercueil. Un cercueil. And the last one. L'orgueil. 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 So this one is only after C or after G. And there's a very good reason for that. If we push a bit the two last one, and we put the spelling as E-U-I-L here, which is wrong, just to show you, don't copy that. So if we read the first one, it's going to be un cercueil. Un cercueil. Because the C is followed by a E, it's going to turn into S. It's not a hard C, it's a soft C. Okay? So un cercueil. So the pronunciation is totally different. So this is why we have U-E-I-L, because the U keep the C as a hard C. And the pronunciation makes sense. Now if we see the other one, l'orgueil with E-U-I-L becomes l'orgueil. L'orgueil. So instead of l'orgueil, it becomes l'orgueil. And it doesn't work. So same thing that with the C, the E after turns the G into a soft G. It doesn't stay as a hard G. That's the only reason why. It's simply to keep the pronunciation. Okay? So this is wrong. Don't forget this is wrong. Don't copy that. Let's do a very quick review of the words. I usually don't do that, but I think for this one it's better. So we have un œil. Un œil. Un œil. Le seuil. Le seuil. Le seuil. Le fauteuil. Le fauteuil. Once again. Le fauteuil. Un écureuil. Un écureuil. Un écureuil. Une feuille. Une feuille. Un portefeuille. Un portefeuille. L'accueil. 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 Un cercueil. Un cercueil.
One more time.
Un cercueil. L'orgueil. 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 Also, I did not explain why the spelling is like that for accueil, because it's a bit more complicated. We will see that when we see hard C and soft C on the lesson, I believe, 33. So you will know everything about this one when we see hard C, soft C. That's it for this one. I hope it makes more sense now for you. Let me know in the comment section if you understand how the sound is built and if you can pronounce it yourself. Tomorrow we start with the consonant and we are going to see B. So I will see you tomorrow. À demain.